This one life to live memory is brought to you by the Kodak Advantic System, a way to take pictures further.
In Paris.
Where are we going?
Right down the street.
Salzburg.
Looks like you ladies are going to have a crash course in downhill racing.
Oh, isn't there another way?
Honey, I always promised you an exciting honeymoon.
Washington, D.C.
Look down there. You recognize that building?
No, of course I do.
White House.
My favorite location was Venice.
Well, you never appreciate a city as beautiful as this until you really get there.
We're on location with One Life to Live in Venice, Italy.
What's this back here?
Oh, that's San Marco Square.
An incredible time of year. We were there in February. The lighting and everything was unbelievable. The whole city's a little crooked, and I just thought it was the greatest.
Happy 30th anniversary, One Life to Live.
Previously on One Life to Live.
Tell Victoria Carpenter that her brother is very, very ill, and she should return home as quickly as possible.
Now, you're suggesting that Barbara is chasing after Kevin? Let's get you up to bed.
Hi, you look so wonderful. I don't ever want to hurt you.
Oh, well, I don't think that's going to happen.
What could possibly make him miss this flight?
Well, now, you know how easily kids can be distracted. Now, Las Vegas has a lot of distractions.
Rappaport. Will Rappaport. Okay, well, it could be William, I guess, or W? All right, thank you.
What's wrong?
It's Will. It's Will, it's Todd, it's everybody. You know, I the poor guy, his father abuses him, and then I force him to relive the whole thing again.
Come on, Sam, you're just trying to help Todd.
Yeah, well, I helped him into a catatonic state.
It's not your fault.
I couldn't help Todd. I don't seem to be doing much better helping my own son.
What's wrong with Will?
He was supposed to be on the plane last night, and he wasn't on it. He just didn't show up. And Lindsay's nowhere to be found.
Well, you know what?
What?
If he wasn't on the plane, the odds are he's still in Vegas, right?
Yeah.
So before you get too upset about it, why don't you call the hotel?
I love knowing a newspaper woman. Thank you.
I think so.
What the hell are you still doing in Vegas?
Dad?
Yes, Dad.
Hold on. Someone's at the door.
Well, look, you were supposed to be on the plane to land with us. I mean, imagine our surprise when you didn't show up. So, it's not a big deal, except your mother and I were just kind of worried to death. So
maybe, I don't know. Will? Have you heard from her yet?
What?
Have you heard from your mother yet?
No, but I think I'm about to. Okay, you said it was urgent. When you called, it's not the church, is it?
Oh, no.
It's not David.
No. Andrew? It's about Cassie.
Is she in trouble?
Yes. And I need your help before it's too late.
Excuse me. Hey, Barbara.
Hey.
Well, you're pretty hammered last night, huh?
Yeah.
You want to talk about it?
No, not really. See, David's in for some tests, and I don't want to wake him up.
How you doing? Wow, you eat all your green beans, don't you? So, how's Manning? Is he still catatonic?
Don't answer that. Mr. Manning's medical information will only be released to his immediate family.
Well, that's all right. I mean, I'm his nephew.
Immediate family means parents, spouse, siblings, and children.
Well, Uncle Todd and I are very close. There's a lot of strong feelings between us.
I'm so glad to hear that.
World News Tonight with Peter Jennings.
Oh, a doctor.
Excuse me, Dr. Lang. My name is Victoria Carpenter. I am Todd Manning's sister. Would you be able to fill me in on his condition?
Certainly. But I would prefer not to do it in front of the man who assaulted him last night.
Assaulted him?
I didn't assault him. I stuck him with a pin.
Kevin, how could you do something like that?
He was quite determined to prove your brother was faking.
He is.
I don't believe you. I do not believe that you could do such a thing. May we talk privately somewhere then? Thank you.
I'm not just worried about Cassie's happiness. I fear for her very soul. And that's why I called you. As a minister, as a friend, not to mention her ex-husband. This misguided relationship with Kevin could ruin her.
Mm-hmm. In other words, you're meddling.
Is it meddling to talk a would-be suicide in from the ledge?
No, forget it. I am not even going to suit up for this game.
You don't care that the mother of your child could be destroyed?
You can pull out the heavy artillery on me now. You know, I was wondering how long it was going to take for you to turn on Kevin. First time not good enough for Cassie. Now he's not good enough for Cassie.
This is completely different. And I am a totally different woman now than I was then.
Yeah, with a few of the old habits still firmly intact.
I see things more clearly now. My daughter is about to marry a morally bankrupt man, a weasel who cannot be trusted
and
about anything.
I have learned from experience not to get involved in other people's relationships.
Oh, please. Andrew, you're a minister.
Exactly. This is none of my business.
Oh, isn't it?
Cassie and I are divorced.
Yes, and don't tell me you don't resent Kevin for waltzing in a year ago and stealing her away from you. It was only your pride that stopped you from trying to win her back.
There may be some truth in that.
Okay, well, I'm just trying to help you undo a ridiculous situation. Come on, Andrew. Remember, pride is one of the seven deadly sins.
And you are the embodiment of the other six.
Yo, Jim, Dennis, get up. Yeah, I'll be right there.
Your mother is part bloodhound when it comes to you kids.
Yeah, look, Dad, I don't got time for this right now, all right?
Hey, don't you dare hang up, all right? Now, just hang on for a second, all right?
You're going to need a little help talking to your mom, so why don't you let me stay on the line and I'll talk you through it, all right?
Fine, now, answer the door before she gets really upset.
Mom, what a surprise. Hi.
Are you okay?
Yeah, never better.
Good, because now I'm going to kill you.
Will?
I know that tone of voice. Believer.
What the hell is the matter with you scaring me like that? You know that I was at the Landview Airport half the night last night waiting for your plane to land, and you weren't even on it. You didn't leave a message, you didn't call, you haven't been answering my calls. I haven't talked to you in how long.
Yep.
I cannot believe this. This is like you have vanished off the face of the planet. And then furthermore, it's like any bit of semblance of responsibility has entered into the brain. And I'd like to know what your explanation is.
Come on.
I'd really like to know what reason there was that you weren't on that plane. I mean it, Will. Tell me. Tell me, why weren't you on that plane?
Yeah, Will. Why?
I meant to be, Mom. Honest. I swear. I was all set to head off to the airport, but I stopped in the casino.
With your fake ID?
Yeah, and the floor manager came over and asked me if I would do him and the hotel a huge favor. So there were some card counters on the blackjack tables, but they couldn't prove it. And they needed me to help them set them up.
I have a newsflash for you. I don't care how old you may think I am, but senility has not set in yet.
Mom, you're not old. All my friends think you're like my sister.
Ha!
She's not buying it now.
Yeah, thanks for the update.
Well, I'll give you a little help. All right, just repeat after me.
Okay, that wasn't the truth. I just didn't want to scare you.
Okay, that wasn't the truth. I just didn't want to scare you.
Really?
I'm 18 years old. I'm
raging with hormones, and I'm supposed to be out to lunch.
You know, I'm 18 years old. I'm raging with hormones, and I'm supposed to be out to lunch.
What?
You know, you are not helping.
Give me that. I'm sorry that Will can't talk to you on the phone right now, but he's busy with his mother.
Look, I'm sorry, hon. I was only trying to help.
Sam? Are you in on this? Is that why you weren't at the airport last night? That is why you weren't there, because you knew he wasn't coming.
No. No, not at all. I just wasn't surprised, that's all. But, look, I was just about to read him the riot act on the phone. You know, I tracked him down there at the hotel, and I was just about to get to it when you showed up.
Listen to your father.
Pal,
listen to me, all right? You apologize. You do exactly what your mother says. I've seen her like this, okay? Trust me. Go home with her. Everything will be fine. Good luck.
I know I messed up, Mom. You know, I just got caught up in stuff here, you know, partying and everything. Lost track of time. I'm sorry. Really am.
Well, what's so funny?
Well, you see, we may have found Will by phone, but Lindsay is there in person, and she is not pleased.
Well, at least you know he's safe.
You've never seen Lindsay angry. How come we always wind up like this?
Like kissing?
It's in my hotel room the morning after.
Well, it certainly wasn't planned. Or was it?
No, not guilty.
Mm. Maybe those little mints they put on the bed. You know, maybe they're just addictive.
Nah, I think it's you. I think you're addicted.
Now, Sam?
What?
Maybe we're just using each other.
Well, I hope that's not all it is.
Well, I hope not either, but... You know, we both are trying to get over other people. Nora, Max.
Yeah, but I, for one, am kind of glad neither of them are here at the moment.
Mm. Both miserable about what's, you know, going on in Todd's life.
Yeah. Well, the truth is, with Vicky out of town, you and I are the only people in Landview who care whether he lives or dies.
Yeah. If two people seek comfort in one another because they understand what the other is going through, do you think that's using?
Not if they're volunteers. But that's a really good question.
And if they find comfort, if the other person makes them feel better or makes them feel safe, then, well, I mean, if that's using that, maybe that's not such a bad thing. What do you say?
Miss Kramer.
What?
Are you trying to tell me you feel sick with me?
I don't know. I've just been so stressed out over the star. One minute Todd's in the hospital, the next minute he's in jail. I just don't know how I'm going to protect her from all of this.
Do what you've been doing. I mean, really, do what comes naturally.
You're a terrific mother. I have this feeling, however, that it's really Todd that occupies a lot of your thoughts.
Well, you know, I had a dream about him last night. I dreamt that I couldn't find him in the fog, and I was searching for him, and I kept catching glimpses of him, but he would disappear in a mist, and then I finally caught him, and I was so... I had this sense of relief when I finally caught him, and then the fog dispersed, and it wasn't Todd, it was Star.
Kind of sounds to me like your subconscious mind is talking to you. I think it's saying, like, well, it was through Todd that Star came into your life, and that you care a great deal about both of them.
Well, I can't save Todd, but maybe I can save Star. I don't know.
Excuse me. By the way, it ain't Lindsay. She's in Vegas. Hey!
Mommy! Lady, what are you doing here?
Hey. I'm sorry to barge in, but I tried calling and the line was busy.
I woke up and you weren't there.
Well, I'm so sorry, but I was taking care of some business with my friend Sam here. Well, I'm sorry, couldn't you have called from the lobby, Kelly?
Excuse me, I must have something to do.
Claire, don't be mad. Look, I did what I thought was best. Okay, you didn't even come home last night.
I was there. You just didn't see me come in. I was there, wasn't I, Pumpkinhead? I read you a good night story. Remember about the green grasshopper? Mm-hmm. I was there, so Sam was just upset about Todd, and so I just wanted to make sure you don't be with him. Make sure he's okay.
Are you mad at me, Mommy?
I'm on your side, Andrew. Yours and Cassie's. That's why I'm doing all this.
You know, I've learned from experience, Dorian, the only side you're on is your own.
And whose side are you on?
I'm not interested in getting Kevin back for anything he's done to me. I'm way past that impulse, and I'm certainly not interested in getting in the middle of anything you think he did to you.
Okay, forget about Kevin. How about Cassie?
What about Cassie? It's like I said, we're divorced.
But not over each other.
Drop it. I know exactly what you're trying to do.
Who did Cassie turn to when I was shot and hovering near death? Who was she with when her fiancé was being held captive in a cellar with Barbara Graham? Who does she depend on? Who does she rely on?
Well, those are her issues, you know, not mine.
Be honest with yourself. Didn't you just have a heart attack? When I a few minutes ago told you there was a problem.
I didn't have any heart attack. No, I didn't. I care about Cassie. Yes, I care about her as the mother of our son.
Please, don't try to con a con woman. Your feelings go infinitely deeper than that. But thank you for bringing up River, because that poor, precious little darling has not been the same since the divorce.
River is fine. Is there no end to your manipulations, Dorian?
In her heart of hearts, Cassie still loves you. And you still love her. Now, isn't that a good enough reason to try to put a family back together again? Andrew?
Mother, Andrew, hi! It's such a coincidence. I was just going to call you. Huh. There's something I need to talk to you about. It's about, River.
I just realized Ming forgot to put the milk out for the tea, so I will go get that and leave you two alone to talk about River. I'll be back in just a few minutes. Judy. Hi.
Hey. How are you doing?
Good. I have a patient admitted today for some testing. Maybe you can remember him. David Rinaldi. For the musician.
All right, Mr. Rinaldi.
Kevin. Good. I'm glad you're still here. I just had a very nice talk with Dr. Lang. He and the other doctors feel there's absolutely nothing that would cause them to believe that Todd is faking this catatonic state.
Well, that certainly doesn't mean that he isn't.
Oh, no, probably the doctors are lying. Maybe they're all involved in a very complex plot.
Maybe they're just not qualified to deal with somebody like Todd, who's as sick as he is.
You are not to repeat your sadistic experiment. Do you understand?
I want you to know something. That experiment, had that worked and he yelled when I pricked him with that pin, I'd be a hero right now.
To whom?
You don't agree with anything I do, do you?
No, Kevin. This is about a lot more than our differences about Todd and the banner. This is about a whole new recklessness in your attitude. Now, what is going on with you?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Yes, you do. I'm your mother, Kevin. And I love you. And I would like to help you, whatever the problem may be. But I can't do it, sweetheart, unless you talk to me.
Everything's fine.
No. Everything is not fine. Not with you. Not with me. Not with our whole family. I went away on that cruise because I really needed to be alone and to have some time to think and sort things out. And I realized that one positive thing came out of our whole experience up at the lodge. And that was that we found out the truth about who killed Georgie Phillips.
Please. And that makes you feel good. Why? Because you want that to absolve Todd of all his other crimes? It's not going to.
No, it's not going to. But this family has an awful lot of healing to do if it's going to survive as a family.
Why can't you stop that? You're not going to fix him.
I'm gathering the whole family at our house tonight at Landfair. I'd be very happy if you and Cassie would join us.
We're going to talk about him?
Oh, we're going to talk about all of us.
Is Ted going to be there?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry I missed the plane, Mom. I was going to call, only I knew how upset you'd be, so I figured it'd be better to wait till the morning. I was wrong. I mean, that's the truth. You could blame Dad. I mean, after all, half my genes are from him. Still, you didn't have to bring the house detective in with you.
This is Clint Buchanan. He's a friend from Landview.
Any friend of my mom's is definitely a friend of mine.
Well, I sure hope so.
So, when did you get to town?
Last night.
Where do you stay?
I'll be the one asking the questions here, young man. What did your father have to say?
That I should apologize and get on the next plane.
That's it. Well, don't expect me to let you off quite so easy.
Well, you never do. There's always a price tag.
What is that supposed to mean?
Well, I think I know that from my own kids. It's called, give the parent a hard time.
You know, this room is disgusting. I'm going to freshen up. Excuse me.
So, are you, just Mom's friend or her new boyfriend? Well, not for me, but maybe for you.
I don't follow.
Mom still loves my dad.
So I still love my ex-wife. But that's a whole lot different than being in love with her.
Are you a lawyer?
No, I'm not a lawyer. You know, love is a funny thing. When you care that strongly about somebody, that feeling doesn't just go away, you know. And it still doesn't mean that you shouldn't leave yourself open to other possibilities. Because if you don't, you might miss out on something that's really good.
Well, if you're referring to my mother, you should have said something that's really great.
Uh-huh. I stand corrected.
You got it.
Yeah, I got it. Okay, now you're going to tell me the river actually wants us to practice
this. He wants us to practice it because we have to play pass the ball at his parents' day at the camp. It's part of the family Olympics.
Yeah, the family Olympics.
Uh-huh.
Oh, boy. Great. All right, then.
Well, I have a surprise for you.
Uh-huh.
David's insisting on coming.
Oh, good.
Which is great. I mean, River's going to be so excited.
Yeah.
He's just adjusting so well at the house.
Oh, I'm glad. I'm really glad to hear that.
Yeah. Thank you so much for helping to bring him back into my life.
Oh, hey, listen. Families are supposed to be together.
Yes, they are. They are. And I'll always love you for doing that. What?
Hmm? What? What? You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Yeah.
Everything's fine. I mean,
I mean, other than the fact that my mother's giving me a hard time.
Yeah, well, that's perfectly normal, right? Okay, I gotta go.
Listen, I promise you I will practice and be in top form.
Okay.
By the time
okay.
the Family Olympics moves along, the agony of defeat. Okay, there's no reason, really, why we need to take two cars to this thing, I don't think. So I'm more than happy to pick you and David up at 9:30.
That's great.
Tomorrow?
Thank you.
Okay. Right.
Oh.
Girl, I could never, ever be mad at you.
Promise?
Cross my heart. No. Why were you afraid when you woke up? Was it because I wasn't there?
I had a bad dream.
You did? Well, what was it about?
Daddy.
You know what? I had a dream about Daddy, too, last night.
Daddy was on a boat sailing away forever.
Well, you know what, Star? Sometimes daddies have to go out on their own adventures. Do you know what? It doesn't mean that he doesn't love us. It doesn't. Anyway, what shape is the Earth?
Round.
Yes, it is. You know what? If Daddy takes off and he sails away and he keeps on going and he keeps on going and he keeps on going, you know where he finally ends up? Right back at home. And guess what? How do sailors find their way? You know, they follow... Point your finger. They follow their favorite star. That's how they do it. They come home. Don't worry.
She's amazing, isn't she?
Well, Blair is at her best when she's with Star. She never knew unconditional love until she had her own little girl.
Well, I guess that's why losing custody hurts so much.
Yeah. I think that Star taught her about the most important kind of love, the kind that's safe.
So you never answered me before. What's the deal with you and this Clint Buchanan? Did you sleep in separate beds last night or what?
Well, that's a heck of a question to be asking your mother.
And that's what psychologists call avoidance. Besides, I got a right to know what kind of man my mother is cavorting with.
Clint Buchanan is a straight-shooting, kind, caring man to whom family is very important. And believe me, I could be doing a lot worse. Oh, there's the boy I remember. Listen, you, when we get back to Landview, first thing I want you to do is to find Clint's daughter, Jessica, and I want you to apologize for not showing the party that she and I put together for you last night.
Mom, do not try to fix me up again.
I am not trying to fix you up. It's just that she and her brother wanted to make you feel welcome, and besides, you owe me for last night.
I knew it. I knew it. The price tag.
Did your father happen to mention to you that he has a new girlfriend?
No. So what is she, the dark-haired intellectual or the blonde bimbo?
Wow, is that how you categorize all the women your father dates?
Pretty much, yeah.
Blonde bimbo.
It's weird. You know, he keeps finding one half of you or the other, but he can never replace the whole package. Okay.
Well, there's only one seat left on the next flight to Landview.
Then which one of you gets it?
Oh, no sport life. You're getting on that plane. Your father's waiting for you, as are other people.
Can you make sure Jim and Dennis get the rest of their stuff? So, what are you two will be doing until the next flight out?
How do you feel about Wayne Newton? To go down for her nap.
Hello. Oh, darlings.
Hi. So, what prompted this summons for a lunch?
What did we do this time?
No, what do you want us to do?
Can't I make arrangements for a lovely little luncheon without being suspected of ulterior motives?
Okay, fine, but we better make it quick because we won't be able to talk once Cassie gets in the room. Sit down, quick. Okay, now what do you think about Barbara Graham? I mean, as a person.
Well, I think she's great. She was great to Star when she was sick in the hospital. She's probably the best nurse they have on staff.
Very sweet girl. I mean, she was nice to me after Ian died. But can she be trusted?
With what? What are you getting at?
Yes, Mother.
What are you getting at?
Hey, you know what? You can't run away from me forever.
I can try.
I want to talk to you about last night.
Look, last night I drank way too much and made a complete fool of myself.
Wait a second, Barbara.
But it won't happen again, okay? I guess it's just what I needed to come to my senses to realize that whatever happened between us is over.
Are you sure about that? Because last night, I mean, you looked like you were pretty much ready to spill the whole thing to Cassie.
I promise it won't happen again. The wine and you are out of my system. Okay? There they are. Hope we can still be friends.
Okay, yeah, I would like that a lot. I'll see you around then.
Well, they've been doing a lot of that lately. I know this is just a lousy way to end a vacation.
I'm very glad you called. Thank you.
Well, I thought that you should know.
You thought right. A big part of the commitment we make to our families and our loved ones is taking the bitter with the sweet.
Yes. Well, let's just hope that there's a lot more of the latter and less of the former.
I talked to his doctor, what's his name, Wang?
Mm-hmm.
And he feels that there might be some sort of psychological basis to this, some trauma. Sam, you're his only friend. Do you have any idea what caused it?
Yeah, I do. It's just that I told Todd I wouldn't talk about it, and I promised him I would never go public with it.
I'm not going to ask you to betray a confidence.
I have a feeling in this case, though, it would be okay. I don't know. I know that you love your brother very much. And, look, if anyone in the world would understand, it would be you.
Well, you have my word that whatever you choose to tell me will go no further.
Okay. You remember the standoff at the country club?
Yeah, I heard about it.
Okay, well, I'd gone in there to talk to Todd to try to talk him into surrendering, and we started talking about all the insanity in his life, and we got to talking about Peter Manning and, you know, the terrible abuse that he inflicted upon Todd.
Well, I know a little bit about Peter. I know he was a monster, and I know about the emotional abuse and the beatings.
Yeah, well, did you know that he tortured Todd? One of the things he used to do was hold a lit cigarette lighter underneath his fingers to punish him.
God.
One night it got so bad that Todd tried to kill him. Really tried to kill him.
Why?
Because the kind of physical abuse that happened got a little different.
Are you saying that Peter abused him sexually?
West and the great beyond. Here's to 30 years of fulfilling our wildest dreams.
Excuse me. I think you're in my seat.
I like the aisle.
No problem.
Ladies and gentlemen, the captain informs me that we have a malfunctioning warning light in the cockpit.
There's no cause for alarm, but we will be forced to remain at the gate until it's checked out. Attendants will be coming around with complimentary drinks and snacks.
Well, it looks like we're going to be a while, huh? And we'll wrap the point.
Congratulations.
We were just making casual conversation until you got here, sweetheart.
Oh, I never realized your conversational skills were so limited. So why the command performance? Don't tell us it's a simple lunch.
It isn't. You know how proud I am of each and every one of you, and what high expectations I have. And I realize that while you are all poised to take giant strides forward as women, you cannot reach out for wonderful new gifts while your hands are filled with old baggage.
Okay, and what would you like for us to put down?
We don't have to give up men again, do we?
Oh, not men in general, Kelly. Just Drew, Max, and Kevin in particular. Am I right, Mother?
You know what? Just fax it to me. Fax me everything you have on Catatonia. Do it, if you can, ASAP. I'd appreciate it. Thank you.
I thought you were going back to the office.
Well, I tried to, but the city room's way too loud, and I'm trying to figure out some way that I can prove that Todd's faking it so I can keep my mother from being sucked in.
Good luck. You know, maybe I can help.
Is that what you're saying? Todd's father raped him?
I suspect that that is true.
Oh, my God.
I could be wrong, Vicky. I could be. I could be wrong.
I pray to God you are wrong, but it certainly would explain an awful lot, wouldn't it?
Oh, yeah.
I have looked in Todd's eyes countless times, and I've seen the pain there, but I never suspected that. I should have seen the signs. Maybe I just didn't want to.
Maybe neither of us wanted to.
Dr. Lang, may I please see him now?
I think that'll be all right. We're finished with the testing for the time being.
Thank you.
Would you like me to go in with you?
No, thanks. Actually, I think there's plenty of ghosts in there to keep me company. Too many.
Stay tuned for...